Robinson was number three. He went out in the Pipe Invitational as well. You hear that horn sound? That's the next heat getting started in the overlapping format and right into the barrel with Pedersen Crisanto to get an early start under Italo and Jansen's priority. Taking down Italo on a mutant section there. Sliding out is Connor Coffin in the non-priority heat as he's getting his warm-up out of the way.
Man,
looked like he was just out of control well before he got to his feet. Holding this rail tight is Pedersen. In the heat with Connor Coffin, gets the completion there as he's fighting for his spot on tour next season. More in the set pots.
Yeah, and I feel for Jansen right now because he wiped out on that first one and now he's pretty much got washed all the way up to the beach almost, Joe. Pedersen Crisanto, what a good wave here from him. Underneath all that chaos, finds a beautiful wave and drops a 3.50. And that is going to bode well for him. That's going to give him lots of confidence moving forward. Slides in beautifully on the backhand, slows himself down, comes out nice and clean. And you know what? Smart kid, rode that wave all the way in and avoided that whole set. Again, you can see him just sliding in nice and easy right there. Now he slows himself down. Easier to do on your backhand. You get to use parts of your body. Engage it with the face of the wave, wipe off that speed, and get yourself as deep as possible. Come out with the spit. Beautiful stuff there from Pedersen.
Frank, if you could be in that headspace during the break.
Yeah, Connor, well, needed to get going, didn't he? Just a 0.5.
It's amazing to take some time to listen to the legendary Jerry Lopez, one of the best, maybe the best ever, to surf Pipeline. Talking about this wave and the dangers. Connor's well aware of Jerry Lopez and his presence, and well aware of the barrel, the back door, getting his best wave so far of the matchup, Potts.
And now starts to get the ball rolling. So 3 points on that left, and then a beautiful little backdoor chip shot here for Connor. Smart move. Also, there's going to be a lot of nerves. You know, you're going to be that nervous feeling in the pit of your stomach. Why? Because waves like this are coming through.
Pedersen, early grab into a massive cavern wave, shoving him down the line. And came close to one of the bigger numbers of the morning.
The spit that it produces is enough to knock you off. You come in contact with the lip, it's definitely going to knock you off. And that's kind of what happened. It kind of, you know what, that wave got full of white water, a lot of spray, so it would have been difficult to see. Very difficult to keep that line as well. You see right there, the wave unloads. He's literally sitting on top of the foam ball. And basically the rest of the wave is by feel, drifting a bit low, connecting with the lip, and that's all she wrote. I mean, that was very, very close to being a made wave.
Thursday for a potential start at Pipe as well, and also Friday. Let's see if we'll be right back in business. A big, wide open pit, shutting down hard on the shoulders of Connor Coffin. And now we'll slide in with Pedersen Crisanto. He gets spit out right in front of his competitor. And now he'll paddle hard to regain first priority. Who is that when he's about 14, 15, getting bombs out here? As we see Pedersen's last.
Yeah, he's looking for a four point ride, no, 3.78. I don't think it's going to get there, Joe.
Remember Bruce Irons kind of clarified it for me a long time ago. He's like, well, a slap in the face is better than diving headfirst into the reef or risking someone's life. And you're, well, that makes a lot of sense. As we look at Pedersen Crisanto living a dream in his second surf at Pipe, getting blown out to safety.
It's under 4 minutes to go. Let's have a look. Takes off, slides in, perfect technique under the hood and comes out with the spit. I mean, that's the best wave he's had in his life here at Pipeline, and he's done it with the jersey on. Super late drop. How's the angle from the water? You can really see the steepness of that wave, the difficulty, the commitment you've got to have, and then the belief in not just your own talent, but the surfboard under your feet as well. That turn right there is super critical. If that board slid just a little bit, that would have spelled disaster. He got the right amount of dig from the fins, the right amount of rail work. Everything just slotted perfectly there for Pedersen and comes out with quite possibly the winning wave.
Potts, this morning when you hadn't even finished your coffee yet, you said somebody might get the wave of their life today. So far, this is the wave for Pedersen in his short career at Pipeline that's just building. But the higher up Pedersen goes, things can change quickly. Guys can fall back out of qualification. So far, so good for Pedersen in to the pit with Yago. He's out of there. Split peak with Connor Coffin. in the priority heat. So Connor needing a 5.91 as he went backdoor.
5.91, one judge gave it to him with a 6, but the rest came under. So majority vote.
Wow.
So one of the bigger names out of the event.